Welcome back in the Pedret Garage. It's time now to find out who's going to be our guest. So
let's go. Check, check, check. Mic, 1, 2, 1, 2. So, guys, who's in the garage today? Let's find out.
Being troubles, connection problem. Anyway, this is time to go join the Pedret Garage. We're live in Paris. I flew all over the seas to come and see and meet our guest today. This is your clue. We're going to talk about ski. Are you okay with that? Yes, we're going to go reach out to the bronze medalist at Olympic Games in Sochi. That was 2014. Then he did it again and grabbed in 2019 the second place silver medal at the World Championship, while he was the World Championship in 2000, the World Champion in 2009. He grabbed nine, you hear that? Nine medals at the X Game, 5 in gold, that's it. And he's 3 times gold, the Globe Trophy for the World Cup, that's it. And maybe his best trophy with Roma, his wife, 2 times a dad with Dali and Rio. Let's connect right now with the one and only Mr. Kevin Roland. Bonsoir.
Hello. Hey, how are you?
This is the audience is worldwide. Hello, Mr. Kevin, how are you?
I'm good, how are you?
Wow, yeah. I saw on your story that you went skiing.
Yeah, I was in Tien today, just to ski a little bit before the season, to take some fresh air on the glacier.
That's right. Because I, you know how I know that. I scrolled your...
Instagram.
Yeah, of course. It's right there. Drop in. So where drop is that? In. It's Pailalès. So
do you think I dropped?
No, you didn't. There's a mistake. But you did some ski moguls.
Yeah.
Training the girls.
The French Federation was...
Did you meet the Olympic champion?
Of course. Perrin.
He was there. Perrin Lafont. So
yeah.
Quick question. Candido Vec started free skiing with moguls. Mm-hmm. Is that what your background is?
Yeah, I grew up in La Plan. We were doing freestyle skiing like old school and new school at the same time. So I grew up doing moguls and the half pipe, slope style, bigger, pretty much every discipline. And at the age of 17, I had to choose because my sponsor was like, okay, you need to do some competition in the half pipe, in slope style, but you have to quit the moguls. And it was kind of tough for me because I was in love with the sports too.
Yeah. Do you still love doing I would say between 5 or 6 turn per second, 100% contact with the snow and going fast?
I'm not that good. I just enjoy doing some moguls. And actually, today it was my first day back in the mogul slope in 5-6 years. So it was great.
We're going to go say hi to the garagist who just came up. Antoine Valla, say hello, is from Lausanne, Switzerland. Bonjour, Monsieur Antoine, La Suisse. Chamonix is in the place. Hello, mon Pedrette. We speak French in the garage as well. Of course, you have two French guys. Welcome back in the baguette and cheese land. Yes, thank you so much. The flight was okay. So, skiing today, how was the snow? Quick question.
The snow was actually good. I was waiting for some glacier snow, kind of hard and icy, and it was actually really good. And kind of warm too, so it was cool.
What a nice day. And you're back in Nancy now, home with the family?
I'm back in Nancy, yeah. I have to take care of the kids now. So I'm back in Nancy. They went to sleep just before the interview, so now I'm kind
of
okay.
Did I say that right? I mean, let's call it one more time, because world champion in 2009, and then you came back in 2019. We're going to talk about that year, 2019. It's a nightmare for you. But before the accident, you happened to grab silver at the world championship, and you have on your belt not one, not twice, not third, but like five gold medal at the X game. You grab the Graal for every single athlete on snow, the big globe, three times, please, excuse me. And did I say that right? Maybe your best trophy is with Roma, 2 kilos.
Of course. There is no question about this. This okay. is this medal that you're going to put in the box somewhere. And
those two,
you don't put them in the box. You great.
You look them smile every up. Day.
Yeah.
Does Rio is still try to ski yet?
I put him on the skis last year, but just for the picture, you know, he was just sliding a little bit. But this year, it's going to be easier.
So, today we're going to talk about this. You just got back in October from the festival. I tried to look that up everywhere. Resilience. This is the movie that guys were looking for it so bad. Where is the trailer? I can't find anything.
There is no trailer. There is no trailer yet. And I'm still dealing with the diffusion. But it's going to be out really soon.
Well, we have to talk because you're here on the Riders TV, and we're going to say hi to all the Odzies, the board, Simeon and everyone. Thank you so much for having us this amazing journey with Riders TV and Total Freestyle. We're going to talk about it and the Pedrette Garage. It's a new place. It's the place for the riders, by the riders, and this is going to grow and grow and grow. We're live on Apple TV, on Roku, on Facebook, on YouTube, on everything you want and can imagine. So right now, resilience, you show this a few times and you got a standing ovation because this is the story of whatever happened in 2019. What is resilience?
So resilience, it's like a small part of my life, an intense part of my life. So yeah, in 2019, in April 2019, I tried to break the world record of the highest hair on the quarterpipe. And something really bad happened. I had a really bad accident where I was almost get it. But just before I get it, I hurt myself really, really bad. I fell in a coma and I was between like, they didn't know if I will survive. But at the same time, my girlfriend, Roma, she was pregnant and she was about to give birth. So a really bad situation, but it turned out that I'm here now, healthy, back on my skis. And I just try to explain all this story in the documentary. And
what a crazy journey. And this is probably the worst period of your life, and meanwhile, the best, Rio, is on your way.
That was the big thing, and that's why I explained during this documentary, is that it helped me so much to have a kid at this time of big my time. Life. I was laying on my bed for 45 days. I didn't move. That was awful, but at the same time, I was the happiest man on earth. Because I was alive, and with this little thing with me, Roma was bringing Rio to the hospital every day, and had the opportunity to see him every day, and that was just happiness.
Look, and I have it.
And he gave me the positivity to, you know, I mean, I really trust that positivity attract positivity. And if you want to do something, you have to be positive. If not, it's going to be really tough. And he helped me. He helped me to recover fast, because I was thinking about, I mean, about just my family and not about the drama.
Yeah, absolutely. Look at this. Look at this picture, guys. I don't know if everyone can see.
Yeah, I was on my chairlift.
This is a beautiful picture. This is the goal that you want to reach in your life. But look at this again. Have you ever got this like look like? If I say, look, if I show you this, you know who's that guy? Who is this?
Yeah.
Keanu Reeves.
Keanu Reeves.
I mean, come on, Point Break.
You think I look like Keanu Reeves?
Keanu Reeves, no kidding.
You think?
Well, yeah, I do. On that picture, obviously, well, let's ask the chat, but look, you're more gorgeous than him. Roma is not there to say it, but I'm saying it.
Thanks.
And Keanu is not there, but look, a little bit the same lips and the hair. When you have the hair longer, maybe, I don't know. Let us know in the chat. Anyway, let's rewind really quick. 2019, you're gonna go to the World Championship. You're on the hunt to grab your title that you got in 2009, 10 years earlier, and you're gonna happen to grab silver, which is not bad. But I guarantee you guys, when you're an athlete such as Kevin Roland, you don't give a half of grabbing silver. You were going for gold, right?
Of course, I always go for gold. But it was, in 2018, I was at the Olympics in Pyeongchang, and I had a really, really bad crash. I was kind of destroyed there, and I hurt myself really bad. And I just wanted to, in 2019, I just wanted to, you know, to be back on the top and back on the top of the podium healthy. And so that was a good thing that I finished second. That was not bad. I was happy with the second position. For sure, every time I'm at the top and I push on my pull, I want to grab the gold. But all in all, at the end, I was kind of happy to grab silver and to be healthy, because a few months later, it was not the case anymore.
So wait, let's rewind again. While you were preparing the World Championship, you had in mind for a while that world record has been held for so many years by the legend Simon Dumont, that skier, reach out the top of like 10 meters and couple inches.
I
believe, or something. And you had in mind to break that record, but it doesn't match. Your agent, your wife, must have been like, what are you doing? Because we're close to the Olympics. This is a big risk. How do you manage this? Besides being the athlete you are, going for gold anywhere you show up at a contest, and go reach out this craziness of going over 10 meters. We have to know that. What is the launch of the quarter pipe? Like 10 meters. So obviously it's 20 meters from top to bottom.
Mm.
Nuts.
Approximately, yeah. The thing is, it's been like 10 years that I'm looking for this quarter pipe record. As soon as I saw Simon Dumont back in 2008, I was like, I want to do this. That's my stuff. I like to go high in the half pipe. That's why drives me in the half pipe, is to go as high as possible. And so I was really interested in on doing this quarter pipe. I tried for many years to organize, but it's really complicated. Like, you need the money, the good sponsor, you need the snow, you need and you need also the window, the sports window, because you have a lot of competition, a lot of training, and you have to find the right moment to do it.
That's the snow we're talking about.
Exactly.
Is that you on the bottom?
Yeah, it's me. And
for this, how insane it is. Look at this.
For example, in 2016, I was supposed to do it, and we didn't have enough snow, so we push it and we push it and we push it, and in 2019 everything was in line. Everything was perfect. I found the snow. I found the La Plagne. My ski resort were following me. Beats by Dre were following me in this story. So I had everything ready to do it. Roma was pregnant. So what should I do? I was like, okay, it's gonna work. I'm gonna make it. I'm gonna do something great, and then I'm gonna have a baby, and everything gonna be perfect. Unfortunately, I mean, that didn't happen like I wanted, but.
Let me fix this really quick. Roma was pregnant. So when you're talking, because she's your partner in life and for the rest of your life, by the way, when Roma is pregnant, is she part of the picture when you go decide to do, because we know like that kind of stuff, it's like skateboarding. There is nothing that is going to go good. And oh yeah, let's go to 12, land and go home and claim it. There is some slam and bad slam, and you did one, and that was scary. All the close friends to you freaked out because you were basically called dead.
Yeah, and but that's the thing.
How Roma, you're not married, but she's your partner. Get into that picture because she's pregnant. You're gonna make her give birth before the birth.
No, we talked together before, but. The thing is, during all my career, I'm scared to hurt myself, to broke a knee, to do an ACL, a shoulder or something. I mean, I'm ready for this. I know that it can happen. I'm ready. But I never imagined that I can go further this. Like I can hurt myself really bad, like dying. It's never went to my mind, actually. So when that happened, of course I was not ready, but Roma was not ready because we never discussed about this. It was not a question for sure. I can hurt myself, but that's it. And for this world record, because I was arriving at 100 kilometers into the quarter pipe, so that means that I was going at 11 meters up in the air. And so it's a lot of stuff, a lot of pressure in the transition that I didn't expect. So I should have take care of everything a little bit better, but it's like this.
Yeah, and meanwhile, the craziest on top of this. So Kevin Roland is our guest today. He's a true talent. A pioneer in everything he did. We're going to talk about video after that. He just did, he's about to release Resilience. But the crazy, crazy time, I don't know if you knew when you were injured at the hospital, but another legend tried to do secretly, because that was a secret. You don't say, oh yeah, come on, I'm going to break the world record. You did that in secret, basically, and tried to break it and do the video and bring it on. There is no audience for this, correct?
Yeah. That was during I wait for La Plagne, my ski resort. I wait for the end. So they shut down. They shut down the resort, and the week after they shut down, I was riding by myself in the mountains.
So did you knew at that time? I'm sure you know now, but David Wise, Olympic champion, tried to do the same thing and injured himself bad. Both of you were in the hospital the same day.
Yeah, kind of. So that was a crazy story because I knew that they built something at the 99 in Austria. They built something to break the world record, but in the easiest way. That means that they put the landing. It was a step up. Yeah, so a step up quarter pipe, which was way...
kind of cheating, excuse me, let's call it.
No, I know that for everybody that know freestyle skiing, they know that it's not the same and it's way more easier.
No, but look, my garage, my rules. You call the rules of Simon Dumont at that time which was like 8 meters with a real quarter pipe. You tried to recreate whatever happened.
The problem was that they were saying on internet and everywhere they break the world record of quarter pipe, and that was not a quarter pipe. So that was kind of my problem.
I see.
That puts more pressure under my shoulder, because I was still doing the world record at this time. When he broke the record, I was doing my stuff. And I saw this, and I saw that all the media was saying, okay, David White just broke the world record, which was not true.
Is that Rio?
He's not happy about going to bed, but...
Aww. If he needs to take a break, I can sing, I can dance. If he needs to go. Daddy duty, family is number one, bro. By the way, we're going to take... If you want to, I can because I have a little job.
No, I'm good.
We have a lot of people. We need to say hello to Antoine, Jeannot from Chamonix, Martin Dacuna, the orange producer. Who is there? Morea Smith is there. Hello. Benoît Panidis, and Willy Boire, Fabien Gromer, Laurent Gay, pro snowboarder from the Pays Basque. Hello. There is a lot of people sending you love. Sylvain Devane, Stéphanie Sieck. Et beaucoup de monde pour toi. Victor, Rémi, Manution, hello, tout le monde. Voilà, regarde. Je ne sais pas si tu vois, if you can see, but I'm putting those comments to you. You see them. All right. Rio, come and say hi. So anyway, you are about to, I don't know when, but you showed it in Annecy at the, somebody that I know very close, Hi-Fi Festival, and you had a standing ovation. What can you say about that movie? Because we don't have a trailer. Come on, give us appetite.
I just show everything, like before, during, and after. Which was
Is this with Matias Lopez, your famous, fantastic partner, friend, videographer?
I mean, he was part of the story too. Yeah, he was part of the
film. So you kept the camera rolling while you were dying.
But my family was filming because they were hoping that I will wake up. So I have a lot of. A lot of footage. Oh shit! It's still.
Seriously, if you need to go, Kevin.
No. My Roma, she's upstairs. Heavy duty. She's taking care of him. So, at the beginning, I was supposed to do a documentary on this world record. So I filmed all my preparation, everything before the record, and of course, everything during the record. It was a really complicated, because we had like a few, like more than 1 week of bad weather. So that was really difficult. And as soon as we had the good weather, that was the day. I had to do it. I had to break the world record. And everybody was there for me. So that pushed a lot of pressure. And that maybe, I think that helped to bring the problem. But so I explained everything, and of course you see the crash, and then you...
Excuse me, Kevin, how high were you? I heard you were 12 meters above the cupping, which is 22 meters from the floor.
I think it's not 12, but it's around 11.
So, hypothetically, you were about to break it that day.
Yeah, it was... The weather
was good, because sometimes the wind doesn't help.
No, the weather was good.
You had all the green lights.
So the thing is, the weather was really good. I say, okay, I try to break it. I pop too hard on the transition. I pop too hard and I land really low. But if you land low, so you go 10 meters high and 10 meters of quarter pipe, 11, and you land low, that means that you land 20 meters and almost on the flat bottom. So that hurt my legs really bad. And I was laying down, and I talked with my coach, and he said, okay, you have to rest, take some time. And I say, okay, no, it's sunny days, bluebird, everybody's here. I'm going for it. So I went back up And I didn't expect that my legs gonna be that weak in the transition after the first crash. And that's what happened. So as soon as I arrived in the transition, my leg, like, I lost completely my leg. So it felt like this and choop. So I went behind the quarter pipe. And I mean, we had an airbag on the deck, but I went behind the airbag and I land pretty much on my neck or my back. I don't remember. But...
Well, that's the picture we're talking about. This is the build. This is, yeah. Is this behind?
Yeah. I mean, I land, I was supposed to, I mean, you don't see the quarter pipe on this one because it was not finished, but I land at the end of the flat. Yeah.
Well, here's a piece that's from I3 Festival. You can see Kevin. Folks, go on Kevin Roland's Instagram right now. It's Kevin-Roland with 2 L. And the joke doesn't work because if it would be French, I said, of course, when your name is Kevin Roland, quand ton nom c'est Kevin Roland, you have to have 2 L pour décoller. It doesn't work. 2 wings, 2 L doesn't work. So forget that. Anyway. So you're telling me in resilience, you have the whole story of it. It's horrific.
I've got the whole story, and it's not a story about sport. It's more a story about life.
A journey. Because,
yeah, you see everything happen with Roma, how Roma had to deal with the baby and the situation. And I mean, how I'm... My passion for sports is strong to try to go back there and everything though. So it's kind of difficult to explain all the documentary like this because it's really intense. No,
we don't want you to kill the story because I like the idea. You're hiding a little bit.
The superhero of this documentary is this girl there. Roma?
Hey Roma, that's the one who should be on the show. That's actually the one who's accurate to speak English.
Yeah, she speaks English way better than me. So,
well, Roma, congrats on saving the babies and this big boy. Anyway, we love you. So resilience. What can we know from now on until it's going to be on air?
What can you know?
Yeah, I mean, is this the film that you're most proud of? Because yeah, I mean, different. You've been, we're gonna, right after this, we're gonna stop talking about the drama, we're gonna talk about the fun right now. And but is this the film that you're most likely super duper proud, and I mean, also can explain, I mean, what's going
yes,
on?
Yes, because I mean, to Brazilian. Me, this movie to me, this movie was like a therapy,
yeah,
because you know, of course, you can imagine that it was really tough for me after this crash to go back and to still want to do some skid, wanted to do some crazy thing. Mentally, that was really hard. And I never had someone to help me for my mind because I feel that when I talk to the camera, when I talk with my filmer, my friend also, it helped me. And during all this documentary, I say everything. I talk about everything. So
well, the camera was your imaginary friend at that time.
Exactly. So all the struggle I was explaining to the camera. So that's why you have the truth. I was really true on this documentary.
And it helped you in some ways.
And it helped me. It helped me, yeah. Because also I was my goal was to be back first to be a normal person. So then when I achieved this goal, I was a normal person. I was walking normal in the street. I wanted to do a skier again. The most important part, I just wanted to be a skier and see. So then I achieved this goal again. And then I was like, okay, I want to be a professional skier again. And that's what happened. And now I'm at the last the last piece of my schedule. And I want to be back on top.
So before we close the chapter on this bad journey of 2019, you broke everything. You had even blood clot in your brain, your lungs, you broke your how do you call this? Sorry, pelvis. Roma, help us. Pelvis.
My pelvis, yeah.
Which was horrible, and you were a million pieces. And some doc, Manu Sion, is one of them. He's specialist as a pro and everything at kinesthesia. Some of the doctor told you you won't be able to even might walk, or you're from La Plagne. I cannot even think about the one of the greatest champion we had in before Perrine was Sandra Laura. She broke with on a jump on the backflip, and she's in a wheelchair, and we cannot even think about her more than that.
Yeah, yeah.
And this is we love her to death, and it was terrible. She this is it. Kevin Pierce in a snowboard situation. You got so lucky, brother. By the way, and you are a good star. And the movie, I cannot wait to see it. And we're gonna close that chapter. And so now you have a piece of metal in your body. What's going on?
Yeah,
are you ringing all the metal time when you go to the airport?
No, but yeah, I've got some metal on my pelvis, and the screws behind my back, and I've got a lot of stuff in my body. But actually, I'm kind of okay. I don't feel that much pain, so I'm really lucky. I feel really, really lucky, because it could have been way worse. And I mean, no.
Mentally, that doesn't help. Somebody, a doctor from science, going to tell you, you might not be able to walk, bro. Did you use that? Because
they didn't tell me behind the goggles.
They
didn't tell me.
The warrior you are. Did you use this as I'm going to war?
No, they didn't tell me that I'm gonna maybe not be able to walk. They say you have to think about something else than skiing, because for you skiing is probably over. And that's some. I was laying on my bed and he said that. I was like, no, I'm not gonna sell some shoes in the street now. I want to be back on my skis. I want to ski again. I'm gonna do everything I can. If it doesn't happen, that's life. But let me try my best.
Kevin, let's rewind one more time, because I don't know if you believe in anything, but the whole mighty decided to put on your way the best medicine ever, which is Rio, happened to come. I think he was born when you were in coma, and Roma came a few days later to introduce you to your baby. And both of you, Roma and you, were at the hospital. She was giving birth. While you were about to rebirth yourself, it's kind of mystic.
Yeah, kind of. I mean, I wake up, she went to see me. She was still with the baby in his belly. She went to see me, and the night after they saw me, she gave birth.
Crazy. That is crazy.
So she gave birth as soon as I saw her, she gave birth. So, but I was still, and you know, I was still not myself really. So after a week, three days after she gave birth, she went to see me, and she bring me the baby at the hospital. And that was like a crazy moment. It's one of the intense moment of the documentary. Okay. When I have the opportunity to see my son for the first time, and I mean, I'm not somebody who cry really, and I'm not really emotional, but for sure
if I could, I would put the music of Rocky right now, Rocky II, The Bells by Bill Conti. I mean, it's resilience, but it could be resurrection. It's a rebirth.
Yeah.
It's a rebirth of the champ. And I'm going to tell you this, Kevin. We know a real true champion can grab all the gold he wants. But a real one, like Pierre Vautier, for example, who went back to the Olympics in 2018, mm-hmm. and he's completely broken. The doctor said you cannot even ride. You don't have a knee. And he's going to go grab
gold. You don't have even an ACL.
Yes.
He grabbed gold without ACL, which is crazy.
And this is how you brand a champion. Champions are good when they win, but when they break and demolished and like I don't know, like a phoenix come back, that's it. That is the signature. That's it. And this is what you're doing. And what we love about you, and I know everyone loves I love you to be on the lifting the trophy, but my favorite image since I met you, you were probably 14 on the SFR tour in 18 with Xavier Bertoni. By the way, he was supposed to come on the show, but he said, no, I hate that guy, so bye-bye. Just kidding. He had a dinner tonight. What we love, it's the face you have when it's your name is on the speaker microphone, ready to drop in with the relationship with your coach, Greg Guéné, and everyone. The mask that you have, the machine you are, I think if Mike Tyson show up, you can punch him and he will fall, right? this moment. How do you relate to what I'm telling you?
Yeah, but the half pipe, this sports is really, really intense. You have to be so focused and it's really risky. So I really have to put myself in this situation, in the zone. I have to put myself in this zone, like a war zone, you know, to be able to transcend myself. And yeah, so that's why you can see my face like, but I'm the nicest guy in the world, actually. But when you see me at the top, you feel like this guy is,
We're not going to ask you for a gum. That's not the moment. Look, Manusion said, warrior mind. Yes. Mental de Viet Cong, I would say, like I am. I was good. The concert was good. The band, I am, the hip hop band.
I am. That was awesome.
Well, Jano is saying, watching you in Crumont and Halfpipe end of last winter, you were back in the game. So before we close that chapter, that's going to be my last question. How did you felt when you first came back on skis after everything you went through? Like, how did you feel? Like the first jump, the first run.
I just feel grateful. Like really
happy cry.
I couldn't believe it because it went faster than ACL. I was back on skis like really, really fast. I mean, that was just turns and I was just taking it easy on slow. But still, I was like, wow. A few months ago, I was laying on the bed at the hospital and someone was telling me that.
Thankful.
Yeah, I was so thankful.
Look, we have a question from Jano. He wants to know, I'm going to pull it up. What did he say? Mr. Jano said, what does he think about skiers and snowboarders throwing triples in the pipe now?
It's just crazy. I was in Sasfel a few weeks ago and I saw like six snowboarder doing triple, six different guys were doing triple in the halfpipe, which is crazy, but really crazy. And they didn't even struggle to do it. They were doing it like finger in the nose. So it's kind of when they do it with style, I like it, you know. Yeah. But it's just that it's really complicated. For the skier,
we used to say the win for spin, or the spin for win, whatever. And it's getting crazy. At that time, we're just talking about 1080. Now it's like triple. It's like over the top.
Yeah, but it's always the same.
And you're back like to back triple plus.
after when we were doing the first double, they were like, it's double, it's kind of weird, then triple, but every time it depends about the style, it depends about how stylish you're in the air. It's not depends about how many spin you do or how many head down you put. It's just the style. And I saw some triple of some snowboarder which were stylish. In ski, we are not there yet. I just saw one triple, one try. No, actually, he landed, but that was kind of sketchy. It's still really sketchy in ski to do a triple in the halfpipe. So I guess it's not gonna be. I mean, some people are gonna throw it in the halfpipe probably this winter, but it's not gonna be perfect this year too.
All right. Before we wrap up this, so you on your way, it's Olympic game again. I can't believe it. It was summer Tokyo and now it's winter because of the crazy pandemic. Somebody just showed up on the chat. Christian Choupin, journalist at France Télévisions, said, I believe I saw this guy this morning. Yep, you did.
Yep, yep.
Okay, all right. So right now we're going to – so Olympic Games, then. Hold on, full in.
Yeah, Olympic Games. I was not supposed to be there. So I'm going to be there with a big smile and try to do my best. But I'm sure that if I do my best, I can do something great.
That's right. Well, Kevin, it was so good to hear the trailer and all the thing you can give us for talking about resilience. And I can't wait to watch the document. How long it is?
It's 45 minutes.
That's good.
So it's not that long.
Cannot wait. And by the way, I freaking love the graphic, the fact that somebody put in your goggles, the air with is there a chopper? There's an helicopter in there.
Yeah.
So resilience, we cannot wait to see this. Now let's talk about something, and I'm gonna bring you back some memories if you would like to see what's going on and talk about this. Kevin Roland is not top athlete, but he's also a pioneer of promoting himself with his true friend, partner, and brother from another mother, Mr. Tony. I mean, you started that journey a long, long time ago with a few, what, six, seven?
Yeah, almost 12 years ago. The what?
This is nuts. You were brilliant. Now everyone does this. You were the pioneer of doing this. And you were doing this while you were competing as well. The camera was there for filming, not good moments, like bad moments, like bad ones with Greg and everyone yelling and...
That was the thing. I mean, we at this time, we were, when you watch some videos, they were like, oh, he won the X Games, he's the best rider in the world. And Freestyle Skiing was not famous. And I was like, with Xavier, was like, we have to explain what we're doing, not just show when we do some crazy tricks in the air. We have to explain that sometimes it's tough, sometimes we're scared, sometimes we cry, sometimes we're happy, sometimes it's funny. And we just try to put everything, like to show everything and to make some video twice a month to show our life of competitor, our life.
Double work, training, grabbing the gold, being on the podium, being funny, editing, filming, everything at once.
Yeah, being ourself actually.
But also, you, because it's not the first time we had an interview, you and I, you told us with Xavier at that time, it helped a lot because going to Aspen, Colorado, when you're a French guy, you're not expected. Plus, X Game is a program made for Americans. They want America to win, no matter what. So becoming a Frenchie and being on top and grabbing, excuse me, 5 times gold medal and two or three of them were in Aspen.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, one in 2010, one in 2011, and one in 2016.
And follow us, Matias Lopez was there. I mean, this also helped.
Of course. No, but that helped for to show our sports and also to show that, when you have some success, and you have all the filming around this success, it helped to show people, to explain who you are and what you do. And it helped to for myself, if to have your best friend on your side. My friends were Xavier, but was also Mathias and my coach Greg. So it was like a family going on a trip and trying our best.
And making a bunch of 100,000 views. What is the best score you had? Because it's all about that now.
So it was really back in the days, and that was the I don't really know. We were on Zapix. We were on the old player, but I think we did like
what a fun joining.
On every episode, we were like 50,000, something like this. But at that time, it was amazing. Really good. Yeah, it was really good.
Talking about video, there is a guy who just released one and just stabbed the stick in the glacier of Zermatt. Have you seen this? Crazy. He hides here, locked in there, home from Zermatt. He's gonna go from top to bottom. He knew that line. Look at this. There is a size of like basically two Olympic swimming pools right there. Look at this. Of course, he's not gonna land it, but he's gonna catch it. This is insane. You know, Marcus? Of course you do.
Yeah.
Ben, that's it. This one is gonna be like insane always on YouTube. Who is the, I mean, you are, but in the big game, can we stay candid, is the one that is unreachable with 27 million views with one of these days?
Yeah, I mean, we all know that Candid is one of the best on doing videos. He always blew our mind. But on this one, that was right before Resilience at the High Five. So that was the movie before my movie.
So I was in the cinema.
I was in the cinema.
Pressure
I was
like, on you.
because it's completely different. I blow my mind. Like, really, I was not expecting. I knew some people that saw this movie and they were like, it's the best thing ever you're gonna see. So I was like, yeah, like you say every time. But it was actually, to me, one of the best edit I ever seen. Well, so I mean, because there is everything. There is some crazy stuff on the glacier, on the ferrite part. There is the freestyle. There is
it's a combination of everything.
It's a combination of everything,
and also a little bit of taste of what Candid did. I mean, going to the cave and riding under the glacier. This is déjà vu, but Mark, you step up the game again. And I know that Candid is right now, while we speak, he's editing his film and is going to come huge and high again. And hopefully, what is your relationship with Candid? He's a little bit older than you. What's your?
Yeah, I mean, I don't have a lot of relationship with him. I know him. I saw him this winter. We skied Crans-Montana together because he skied a lot of time. I mean, during all winter he was in Crans-Montana. I guess he's doing some filming there, and I was there for skiing halfpipe. So I saw him, but we all know that. I mean, Candy do his thing in his side and his work on his project in secret every time. So we don't have
he's a Daft Punk of skiers.
Exactly, yeah.
Well, we love him so much. Anyway, we cannot wait to see what he's going to come up for. But look, you came up with that, bro, and that line was not that easy to do with, again, Mathias Lopez. Oh my gosh. That is a lot of preparation to do that one. Let's talk about it.
Yeah. I mean... especially
just
this
that,
shot.
Just that shot. Explain us that shot.
That shot, you can see the on my Instagram, I guess. You can see the footage when at first we put some salt on the wall, and the wall didn't move, so I crashed on the wall. I mean, you have to see the footage.
Yeah, we'll go. Go join right now while we speak. Kevin Roland, if you're not following him, his Instagram is insane with his son Rio going to water and stuff like that, and he'll show you some backstage and behind the scene of what's going on. So here's watching, oh my gosh. And the purpose of the line right there is to play with the videographer, hiding with the relief and you popping out.
Yeah.
Is that correct?
Yeah. The thing was to, you don't see the jump, you don't see the landing, and you just see me in the air or skiing. I was kind of a ghost. That's why we said, oh my ghost.
Insane. That was like 2 years ago? Before the
pandemic? That was at the end of 2018. Yeah.
Here we go, and then the big finish.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, all right. Kevin, so right now we were supposed to have Greg to say a few words, because of course he was there that big time. We talk about resilience. Your film is going to come up hopefully soon. Do you have like a no deadline when we can see this? Because now we have an appetite and we want to see it.
So we're going to see it right before the Olympics, probably, at the beginning of the winter.
Wow. On France Télévisions, Christian Choupin, ready?
Maybe, maybe not.
I'm not going to pull the string. We'll find out soon. And we can
it's gonna
wait.
Be, yeah.
Congratulations for that film. What else? So the kiddos are good. And quick question: your dad now, your parents, your mom, and your grandma. I believe you have a relationship with your grandma still.
Mm-hmm. Of course.
At that time, they had a hard time. It was tough to be a very close family from you, because my question is, and that is in the mouth of Roma as well. What if Rio or Dali wants to follow your journey, knowing what you've been through? Think about it.
Yeah, I know. I mean, I think I just want to know if they really want to do it. Like, they have to be passionate. They don't have to go do some freestyle skiing, some crazy stuff. If it's just to do it like your father and you're not really crazy about it, because to do this sport, you have to be like a big fan of your sports. You have to live for this. And I just want to be sure. If I'm sure of this, I'm going to help them. And I'm going to help them to don't do any mistake. And so, yeah, I'm going to be behind them.
And for those
but
kids,
that's not the goal.
It's a what? Pressure to be the son of an athlete like you, because soon as you come up on the, I'm just gonna say, like, I'm friend with Guy Forget, a famous tennis player. His two sons, he had a huge hope for them to be superstar tennis player. But when you show up on a tournament with the name of Forget, it's hard. So the same name of Roland, Rio Roland, or
But that's why I really don't
care. You got
care
punched
about
right away
anything.
When you don't even ski. That's
yeah,
what I meant.
No, I mean, it's like the normal word of a father, but I just want them to be happy and to do what they want and to what they love. If they love skiing, they're going to go ski. If they love dancing, they're going to dance.
Rio is what now? 2 years old?
Two and a half. Dali is 7 months.
Does he call you Mitch?
No, yes.
Hey, Mitch.
Papa,
of course. What is that nickname, by the way, Mitch?
Mitch? It was when I was like 12 years old, something, at the Club des Sports, at the ski team. Mitch Buchanan from...
Here we go. Is that because you always, if you don't know Kevin Roland after he's done skiing, he's the one, I'm so sorry, Roma, I'm not trying to sell your husband right there, but he's one of the most talented athletes of his generation. But look at him, he's right there He's one of the most gorgeous guy. I mean, he's a model. Was that because you were trying to put like, do you have this in your bag?
Yeah, that was the thing. It's because one day.
I bought this for you today, by the way. I was like, okay, I'm going to talk about this. You always have, you take off your helmet or beanie. Kevin Roland has always the wave perfectly shaped.
Like, no, that's not true.
Yes, sir.
That's not true. I've got always something on my head, and because when I was a child, I was putting some stuff in my hair before going to bed. So one day they say, "Hey, you're Mitch Buchanan. You have to take care of you." So whatever, it's following me all my life. It's gonna follow me all my life.
Okay. quick, before we're gonna leave, do you know Nuit de la Glisse?
Of course.
Have you been in one of the movies?
No.
Well, I'm here in France, and I'm so happy I didn't return for 2 years. We're gonna make a quick break and watch what's coming up next week, starting in Geneva, Lausanne, and then touring in 15 cities. Let's watch the trailer of Nuit de la Glisse right now. I'll be right back.
Their achievements make them exceptional. We should remember that their lives revolve around the seasons, with moments as vital to our existence as a sunrise or a sunset. Beyond performance, what is important is their state of mind and way of life that brings meaning to their lives.
De la Glisse on tour right now. This is only in France, by the way. The show will be coming in the US in 2022, and hopefully one day we're gonna see you in Nuit de la Glisse. I know the guy quite well, Thierry Donard. So have you ever seen one?
Of course. You talk to me?
Yes.
Since I'm a child, when I was younger, I was watching it like all day long.
Yeah, that's right.
Well, and I still do.
And you know what? I wish and I hope you can show resilience, because I think it's very inspiring. To like Le Grand Rex, having this film, because I do believe this therapy is still going on. Now you need to share this with the audience, and you need to be in the audience and see this with 3,000 people watching it, and then come and meet and greet with you, Kevin. It was lovely to have you. We're almost an over 58 minutes. I'm gonna let you go be on daddy duty or mommy duty. I don't know too much.
Now the baby are sleeping, so I'm gonna take.
Well, it was so cool to catch up with you. We cannot wait to see resilience, of course. But before you go, we have a giveaway game, but we're not gonna give away. We decided with the team to do like a huge Christmas. Like we always did on the garage. And it's time to make win this, but you're not going to win anything tonight. You have to enter to the giveaway contest on Riders TV. So follow Riders TV right now on Instagram. Go, hurry up. You're going to see cool stuff like the Total Freestyle, the Pedal Garage as well. Have you heard about this? This is the revolution of skiing. I tried it with my son. It's insane. If you would have that, by the way, you're going to have two for you. To try this with Rio. It's fun. You put this on your helmet and you can totally communicate with all your people that ski with you. If you have like 10 people, if they have it all, you can trash talk. Can you believe it? You're on the top of the slope. And because while we're skiing, it's individual. You ski and you stop and blah, blah, blah. Trash talk while you ski. Is that right? Funny.
And you have to give one to Greg, so when I'm in the air, I can say, ah, open!
Well,
you're going to crash!
You're going to send me your information, and we're going to send you one. It's the Pack Talk Ski, and we're going to make you win this during Christmas. We're going to do huge Christmas on December 23rd, I believe, with Laird Hamilton. The show is on. You're going to see a lot of giveaway. We have Tony Hawk's boards, by the way, and that's it. So, this is from Cardo Snow. So follow Cardo Snow right now. Go on Riders TV, follow them, and make sure you're going to enter the contest. It's insane, okay? Look, you want to see how it looks like? Here it is.
Hey, something's missing, huh?
One of the best days, man. One another best day.
The view is amazing.
All right, here we go.
All right, guys, follow me. We're going this way, right here.
Nice turn.
Yeah, I'm catching up. I'm catching up. Here I come. All right.
Go fast.
Pretty amazing.
Look to your left, man. What a view.
Oh, my God. What a session. Best snow ever.
That's it. So we're going to make you win this. And Kevin, already for Christmas, this is from Riders TV. If you don't mind, we're going to ship this to you to NC, and I can't wait for you to see it. You can, if it's freezing, you guys, it's like 5 seats behind you on the chair. Well, you can talk to them and still trash talk. You get a call from Greg, and you're only you on the call. If you want to, you can share the call to all the other helmets. Is that crazy? You can listen That's to cool. music. And you can decide to put pressure and put the song to disturb the other one. It's fun. This is a complete fun experience. And this is going to be our Christmas present for you. Really quick, Thanks. Do you know the name Tony Hawk?
No, no. Who is it?
Do you skate, by the way?
No. But I know Tony Hawk.
Tony Hawk is the legend. And we met him for Total Freestyle. And right after this, we're going to let you go. This is the trailer of episode 3. And Tony Hawk, believe it or not, is the only athlete that has his own episode with The Simpsons. And this is what we're going to talk about.
California, it's time for Total Freestyle with my friend, Pedro.
Here we go. Check it out.
Hey, guys. Welcome to Total Freestyle, a chill moment to discover your favorite riders. In the last episode, we started our chit-chat with the skateboard legend, Tony Hawk, at his warehouse. We asked Tony if he would rather redo the loop or the 900. Scary question. And we started to talk about his legacy. Today, let's get deeper into that. Chit-chat.
We're not that far away from Hollywood, and you've been working with the industry of like movies and stuff like that. What is the best appearance you did or you made that makes you so proud?
The Simpsons. It's the best.
Up next on the halfpipe, boarding legend Tony Hawk.
Here we go. So now you can go right at this minute, go jump on Riders TV. It's free. You can see the whole episode. It's freaking amazing. Can you believe, Kevin Roland, your name is known for all the titles that you won? The name, that was the main question to Tony Hawk. Why is such a legacy? Do you know the answer? Of course, he's a legend. But the answer is because of the video game he did. And you did a video game. Steep.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I helped them to develop the
You
video
were not
game.
Quite happy with the video game or what?
No, no, I'm really happy. That was cool. That was really cool to bring the real freestyle into this game because they didn't want to do something cheesy. So they needed me to have the good information for the tricks, for the grab, for the stuff. That was really, really cool. Cool experience.
Well, Kevin, I'm going to let you go back. Thank you so much for following us. And it's a tribute to something that
thank
we
you.
Quit with. Thank you so much for taking a break. And please send a ton of love to Roma, the kiddos. Hope to see you very soon on the slope, on the top of the Olympic Games. And that's it. You have a message to say to somebody?
I love you all.
We're going to say bye-bye to Chanel, Laurent Gay, Benoît Panidis, Laurent, Benoît, il y a tout le monde qui est là. Manu Sion, également Marcus, et, bref, Christian Choupin. On vous dit à bientôt. On se quitte en image avec ce qui nous a fait tant plaisir. On retourne avec Follow Us et on embrasse bien sûr notre ami Xavier Bertoni. Salut Kev.
Ciao, ciao.